Today you have represented the three neighborhood schools. So you have Danville, Atkinson, and Pollard. Each of us have a pre-K program. So I'm Megan Corcoran. I'm the assistant principal at Danville.
I'm Patrice Liff. I'm the interim principal at Atkinson Academy.
I'm Doug Blay. I'm the principal at Pollard. And welcome to any penguins coming our way.
And I also have Ashley Smith with us today, who's waving at you. She is one of the district pre-K teachers. So she's here to help us should any questions come up that are program specific. She will be here to help us with that. Dean just put up a message letting us know that we are recording. So these will be posted for you at a later date if you cannot make it. All right, I'm going to share my screen, I think, because Amy's sound is still not working. So give me 1 second.
Megan, why don't you introduce Amy? I don't think everybody heard her introduce herself.
Okay, guessing if Amy still does not have sound. Amy Daly is our district pre-K and special ed elementary coordinator. So she will be here to help, particularly with any special ed questions you might have coming up with students coming into pre-K. All right. I'm assuming everybody can see that. Okay. So our pre-K, our pre-kindergarten curriculum includes early numeracy, early literacy, executive functioning skills, science, exploring the social world, social and emotional development, creative expression, cooperative learning and play, and health and physical development. So a lot of what they do is play-based and it happens through play, but all of those skills are covered. So a day in the life of your pre-K student. So each classroom will have their own arrival routine. They typically have some sort of morning meeting or hello circle, kind of welcome students into the classroom. Throughout the day, they will have some independent reading or shared reading, some teacher-directed learning centers. Those can be literacy-based, math-based, social-based, just teacher-directed learning. They'll always have a snack. There'll be some music and movement. Student-directed and teacher-supported exploration. There's always some sort of goodbye circle or closing meeting at the end, and then a dismissal routine, which might look a little bit different from classroom to classroom, but generally they are the same. When your student comes to school, some things they will need will be a backpack, a snack, a drink, and a change of clothes. So some program details, a student must be turning 4 by September 30th in order to be in the pre-K program. Our program will run 4 mornings per week, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday from 8:30 to 11:15. And it is $2,200 per year. You can pay it in full at the beginning of the year, or you can pay it in 10 installments of $220. So for transportation, we get this question a lot. AM students can be transported to school from home. You are responsible for the midday transport. However, I think that first one was supposed to say on the bus. So in the morning, pre-K students can ride the bus. However, we do not have midday transportation home. So parents are responsible for that midday transportation. And then students who live in other district towns must provide their own transportation. So for example, if you are an Atkinson family, but where the program is full, if you chose to enroll your student in Danville, you would just be responsible for that transportation. So in order to register, you'll go online. All of our registration's online. It's at timberlane.net/enrollment. You will need your child's original birth certificate with the raised seal to the main office. They'll make a copy and then return it to you right away, so we don't hang on to that. You'll need to bring your proof of residency to the main office. And that could include a property tax bill, mortgage statement, and utility bill, or two different utility bills. And all health forms will be returned to the main office for the school nurse as well. Oops. And then if you have additional questions, we've put everybody's contact information here for you. You can also look all of this contact information up online. So that is our short presentation, but we'd like to open it up for questions now. So there is a question spot where you can type questions in. Or Dean, correct me if I'm wrong, if they raise their hand, you can unmute them for a question.
Yes, absolutely. Anyone who would like to either raise their hand and ask a question, we can put them on, or if they would like to use the Q&A, and it looks like some items are coming in there.
Will students be required to wear masks? At this time, currently, our policy is that students in the building are masked. We do not have a directive on what next year will look like. Anybody else can jump in too.
I'll take the next question. Says, do they offer full day if needed, or is it all half day? It is only a morning program at all three of the elementary schools.
However, I believe they can contact TLC for peer partners, which would be all day, correct?
That's correct.
That is correct. And peer partners is an application process and an interview process for peer partners.
How about I read it and then somebody else can answer it?
Okay.
Do we need proof of residency if we had an older sibling in the school already?
Yes, you do.
Can you repeat the school days again? Which days are we holding class?
Tuesday through Friday next year.
I thought we registered early in the year, or do I need to re-register? Also, how do we know if the child has been accepted? If you've already registered, you don't need to re-register. I can't answer for the other schools, but I believe the Atkinson students have been notified.
And there is
a wait list, right, at every school.
There is a wait list at all the schools except for Danville, I believe. And if you're a student that registered at Pollard, you were informed whether or not you were in the program or not.
At this time, all students who have registered in Danville, there is room for. If you are an Atkinson or Pollard family who has been waitlisted, we do have room at Danville and you are welcome to register there. You will just need to let us know.
The next question is, can I just drop off the birth certificate and other forms whenever the school is open, or should we make an appointment to drop something off?
I know at Pollard, it's okay to come anytime during the school hours. We're there. Our registrar at Pollard is Fran Allen. So you definitely want to talk to Fran. She takes all that paperwork and does all the registration. So you at Pollard, you would want to talk to Fran Allen. Each school does have a registrar that you should probably contact.
Yes, same with Atkinson. Our registrar is Sandra McKay.
And for Danville, you can just show up too during open hours.
Is there a transport system in place for those going from one school to TLC if that's the route we choose? I don't know that that's optional. Amy, do you want to answer that?
I guess I just want clarification on what you mean by a transport system. Can that parent?
Yeah, when you say going from one school to TLC, if you go to a separate town, so if you do not live in Sandown and you choose to go through TLC, you would be responsible for transportation. I think that's the question.
If not, just you can raise your hand or we can follow up with another question.
The next question, are there snack requirements or restrictions? It's a good question.
We would let you know if it was a nut-free classroom. We do not automatically make everything nut-free unless we need to due to an allergy in the class, but we would let you know in advance.
And the next question is similar. What is the school policy if you have a tree nut allergy. And we just have nut free classrooms in that case.
Yeah, we're a tree peanut sensitive school, but a lot of that's done through our nurses, and we don't have peanut free schools.
Just another question. Can we go by the office anytime to bring the paperwork? Yep, that works for all buildings. If they were notified, they should have received either an email from us or a phone call. They're asking how students were notified.
I know the students at Pollard, there was a phone call.
This is from Shannon, who says she registered her son at Pollard, but has not heard back, Doug.
Oh, I can talk to Fran tomorrow, or you can send me an email and I can double check.
And again, someone from Danville saying that they've registered as well, Megan, but haven't heard back.
Yes, I just sent them a message back.
Okay. And so two people saying thank you. You're very welcome. Anybody?
As of right now, there are only wait lists at Pollard and Atkinson. There are not wait lists at TLC or at Danville. So that's why you may not have received a call, because we do not have a wait list. So if you've registered, then you are in the class.
Yeah. Any other questions?
And if you think of questions and you have not quite at this moment, feel free to always call the schools or reach out via email. We're happy to answer any questions that come up for you. All right.
Thank you everyone for coming tonight.
Yep, thank you very much. We appreciate you all attending, and we'll see your kiddos soon next fall.
I look excited for all our new friends. Have a good night, everybody.